this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Fortinet Security Fabric to gain additional visibility into your network, as well as highlight some of the new features in FortiOS 5.6 that will give you the confidence that your network is secure. Let's start by taking a look at what the network looks like with Fortinet Security Fabric disabled. In this topology, we have a bunch of FortiGates, several FortiAPs, FortiSwitches, and a lot of endpoints. However, you can see from the Security Fabric widget on the dashboard that there is only one main office FortiGate. If we look at the physical topology in FortiOS, we're only going to see the main office FortiGate as well as some FortiGates downstream that appear to be sending all of the traffic. If we move down to the All Sessions view on FortiOS, we can see that all of the sessions appear to be coming from the FortiGate, so we have no visibility into the network behind that FortiGate. Let's take a look at what it looks like once we turn Fortinet Security Fabric on. If we go back to the dashboard, you'll see in the Security Fabric widget that it's disabled. We can easily jump to the Security Fabric settings page here and turn on Security Fabric. Let's do that now. Now the Security Fabric is enabled, and when we reload the dashboard page, we're going to see that the Security Fabric has now had several FortiGates join, and we have additional visibility into that network segment. If we move down to the physical topology, we now can see both the main office FortiGate as well as the first floor FortiGate, the second floor FortiGate, as well as a FortiSwitch, a FortiAP, and a bunch of devices and servers behind each network segment. This gives us the additional visibility into those segments as well as into the endpoints and the devices behind those segments. As you can see here, there are a large number of devices detected in this topology. Let's try to make some sense of it by seeing what FortiOS has learned automatically by enabling the Security Fabric. First, we'll take a look at the devices connected to the FortiSwitch on the first floor. Zooming in on the bubble cluster is going to give us some details about each device, including its hostname as well as the operating system it's running. If we hover over the device, we'll be able to see full details for that endpoint. In this case, we have Bob's laptop, and he's registered with FortiClient connected to the first floor on the engineering team VLAN, running Windows. New in FortiOS 5.6 is the ability to detect social IDs. In this case, we've detected Bob's Twitter account as well as Bob's Gmail account. Let's take a look at another device. In this case, we have the CFO's laptop. He's running Windows. You can see his IP address is 10.1.1.2 and that he has a lot of vulnerabilities. He's also connected to the engineering team VLAN on the first floor, and we've learned his social IDs as well. Assuming you wanted to find out which devices on the network have the most vulnerabilities, there's an easy way to do this in FortiOS 5.6. From the top, we can sort bubbles by the number of vulnerabilities in the network. This gives us a new view where you can see which device has the most vulnerabilities and zoom in to find out what those actually are. In this case, we found out that the CFO has the most vulnerabilities on the network. If we right-click on his device, we can drill down to the vulnerability details. Here we have a full report of all of the vulnerabilities detected on his endpoint. In this case, it appears to be a lot of vulnerabilities using Google Chrome. Now let's take a look at another powerful feature of the Security Fabric in FortiOS 5.6, the ability to search through the topology. Let's assume that HR has asked you to build a case against a problematic employee. In this case, we'll use Bob as an example. From the search bar, we can search for Bob by his hostname. The topology view is going to highlight where Bob is in the topology, and we can see in this case that he's connected to the FortiSwitch on the first floor. If we hover over his device, we can see the username, as well as the IP address, and all of the other details we saw earlier. You can also search for Bob by his IP address. In the same case, we're going to see that he's highlighted, and you can see that it matched the IP address on the device. Now let's drill down and see what Bob's doing. What we're interested in now is the applications that Bob is using. If we go to the Applications tab, you can see that Bob is currently using a lot of traffic sent to YouTube. Now let's assume that we wanted to create a policy to block YouTube and Netflix for all employees. In FortiOS 5.6, this becomes a lot easier with the new inline policy management. Here we'll go to IPv4 policy, create new policy, and we'll pick the applications directly inside the policy. In this case, we're going to block YouTube as well as Netflix. We'll create a deny policy, and we'll pick the first floor going to WAN and all employees here. And that's it. Creating this policy is going to block Netflix and YouTube for all employees on the first floor. Additionally, you can also manage URL categories directly in line by clicking on the URL category section. This allows you to manage web filter traffic based on URL category directly inside the policy. Now let's take a look at historical information. In the security fabric, all data is sent to a FortiAnalyzer for analysis from each individual FortiGate in the fabric. In this case, we're looking at real-time data from the FortiGate itself. You can tell because the time period is set to now and the FortiView data is from the FortiGate firewalls in the fabric. However, if we change the time period to something longer, let's do 24 hours, we're going to see that the data is loaded from FortiAnalyzer and aggregated for all devices in the network. We're also able to do longer time periods, like 7 days. This information is all available from drill down through the topology views as well as directly from within the FortiView menus. Additionally, you get all the same drill down functionality that you see in the other FortiView pages, but directly from FortiAnalyzer within the FortiGate interface. Now let's take a look at how we can tie some of these features together to identify the critical assets in the network and see how many vulnerabilities they have. Let's start by searching for critical. You can see that two devices match under the FortiSwitch on the first floor. If we zoom in, we can see which devices those are. First, we have the CEO's laptop, and you can see that his laptop has the asset tag of critical. If we move over, we can see the CFO's laptop also has the asset tag of critical. If we want to find out which of those devices have the most vulnerabilities, we can sort the traffic by the number of vulnerabilities rather than the amount of bandwidth they're using. Let's do that. Here we can now see that throughout the entire topology for all of our critical assets, the CFO's laptop has the most vulnerabilities and the CEO's laptop has the second most. This allows us to drill down and take some action to correct the vulnerabilities on that network. In the previous example, I showed you how to identify the critical assets and which of those have the most vulnerabilities in the network. Let me briefly show you how you can tag those devices with the critical asset tag. From User and Device, Device Inventory, you can select the device you're interested in. And while editing that device, you can add an asset tag. In this case, we'll assign it the tag Critical. However, you could also assign it a new tag, for example, Engineering. This tag would then appear inside the topology views and allow you to search through the topology to find devices with that asset tag. Now let's use the security fabric to try to answer the question, how secure are we? Let's start by looking at the security fabric risk widget. Here you can see that the score is 625 and the compliance is 64.2%. This is a score that's calculated by running a series of tests across the entire fabric for all of your FortiGates, FortiSwitches, APs, and endpoints. Let's drill down to see what actually contributed to that score, and then we can try to improve it. Here we can see that the fabric has identified the three firewalls in the network. We can hover over each one to get details if we're interested in that. If we go to the next step, we're going to see all of the recommendations that are available and how they contributed to the score. First, you'll notice that the risk score is the same as what we saw on the dashboard. Some of the things which have been identified are that the main office firewall and second floor firewall are not registered with FortiCare. On the first floor, there is an out-of-date version of firmware running on the FortiSwitch. Looking at the second floor, we have a bunch of devices that should have been replaced with FortiGates, which would add additional visibility into those network segments. On the main firewall, we have an HTTP server that's not connected to a DMZ network segment. And on the first floor, we have some policies that haven't been used in the last 90 days. You'll see if we scroll down that it also has identified some issues with the FortiClient vulnerabilities on some of the critical devices. Here we'll see that the CEO's laptop and the CFO's laptop also have those vulnerabilities that we saw in the previous steps. You can also see that these are the critical assets based on the asset tag. Some of these recommendations can be applied automatically. You can see which ones by the Easy Apply tag that's shown within the security audit here. Let's go to the next step and see how we can actually resolve some of these. On some of our firewalls, we have outbound connections to botnets not blocked, so we can improve the overall security score by blocking these. This will solve 3 high-risk vulnerabilities on the network and should contribute to the security score. On the second floor, we can also disable Telnet, which will improve the score again. If we apply the recommendations, changes will be made on all of the firewalls in the fabric, and the configuration will be updated automatically and backed up locally to my firewall. Let's take a look at the changes that were actually made. On the main office firewall, set scan botnet connections to block was changed. On the first firewall, the same change was made. And on the second floor firewall, we also blocked botnet connections, but we also disabled telnet access. All of these changes are available for review and backed up locally. Now let's run the audit again to see if our security score changed. And now you can see that our risk score has decreased to 505 and that our compliance has improved. And when we return to the dashboard, we're going to see the same results, giving us the confidence that our network is more secure. These are just a few examples of how you can use the Security Fabric in FortiOS 5.6 to gain additional visibility into your network segments and make continuous improvements to the security of your network.